Class C-2 state champion Hastings St. Cecilia Hawkettes. With us today is Coach Greg Berndt and players Lexi Vertin, number 10, who scored 17 points today and 57 for the tournament, and Makenna Asher, number 23, who had 18 today and 41 for the tournament. And Coach Berndt, I'd ask you to start out by giving us some general thoughts about the game.
You know, I think watching them play last night, they were totally the aggressor to Fillmore Central, and they really kind of took it to them. And, you know, talking through with assistant coaches last night, what was our game plan? And our whole mantra all year has been to be the more aggressive team. You know, we didn't really zone press at all yesterday because of some of the guard play. And we just basically said, you know what, we're going to be who we are. And we've been the aggressor. And we kind of came out in that. I don't know if it kind of threw it for a loop or it kind of got sped up or whatever it was. It led to some turnovers there, and it's an easy offense for us in that first half.
Questions?
Great. You talked yesterday about the natural progression that this group's kind of been on. Finally capped off the state championship in your third year at Allen. I mean, how fulfilling is that?
It's excellent. You know, starting out with Lex, first year, when she was a sophomore with Gracie, too. You know, there was a lot of question marks. You know, the school's all-time leading scorer. I just graduated. Forget the new coach. We don't really know what to expect. And from day one, I basically said, you know, the expectation doesn't change. We want to get back to state every year. That's the goal. And that first year, we had two awesome seniors, and Lucy Scope, who's playing volleyball at Hastings College, and Claire Espeson. And they really set the tone for us, and I really owe a lot of gratitude to them for kind of helping set a culture. We fought our way and got to state. The next last year, again, fantastic year, far away in the semifinals, and today I hope all that experience kind of propelled us yesterday into that game today. And it satisfied because once we got to this stage, there's a lot of times in that game where we could have panicked, and there wasn't really any panic, there's a lot of composure. So it's just, I feel so happy for, you know, Grace and Lex and everybody else that they won this, because they were probably the most deserving team here this weekend.
Yeah.
McKenna, what's this mean to you to kind of win another state title, especially with your family success?
Yeah, it means a lot. I mean, watching my brothers and my dad get two in a row, my dad getting five here, it means a lot. This is what we dream of as little kids growing up, and finally got one for myself.
Jeff?
Lexi, can you tell us a little bit about what this week has been like for you? You averaged 9 points a game coming to the state. You go for like 17, 19, 21. What allowed you to have that success this week?
Well, it's my last tournament ever, and I'm not playing basketball next year, so I was like, hey, let's go out with a bang. You know, I had a little injury in the midseason, which kind of set me back there, but that really drove me to push myself to become a better person and a better player. And I did it for my team, my family, and everybody that supports us.
Yeah.
What did your defense do to them, you think?
I think it's kind of like we girls sometimes touch on that too, but I think we kind of were the more aggressive. We talked one of our keys, you know, last night coming up the game plan, because they looked awfully impressive yesterday, like dominant and impressive. And we said we have to disrupt what they want to do offensively. And I think our, you know, our 1-2-2 press really slowed down them getting out and running. And that's what they want to do. They want to get out, you know, and work for one quick good shot. And I think it really disrupted them in the half court. I think just some little wrinkles we kind of threw at them, we didn't really get, you know, allow them to get any rhythm. So, and that's a credit to our kids. I mean, if you talk to anyone that's played us this year, we really don't give in on that end of the floor. I mean, I always tell the kids, the offensive end is yours, the defensive end is mine. I mean, there's not going to be any let-ups on that end. You guys have a lot of freedom on the other. So that was evident today, and they really, really took that to heart.
Well,
I thought Tori Thomas had a great game. She had a double-double and really slowed down the Sprocket girl.
Yeah, I mean, and Tori Thomas, she's a nice player. You know, Tori yesterday struggled. I mean, it was kind of uncharacteristic. She's probably our most improved player from the last year and the year before. I mean, she's had a phenomenal year. Averaging, I mean, I don't know how many double-doubles she's had post-Christmas. But yesterday she really struggled. We, you know, coaches pulled her aside last night and talked to her and said, don't quit believing in yourself. Don't quit. Believe the team doesn't think anything less of you. You come out tomorrow. Tomorrow's a new day. You know, she got that first bucket. She looks around and starts smiling. Oh, it is a new day. And from there, it just, you can tell that same kid was back. That would have been a whole year.
Doug?
Lexi, yesterday you had the big lead against Oakland. Craig,